again, everyone, and welcome back to the Bitcoin Business Bureau. I'm your host, as always, Litecoin Leader, and today we've got a real hot one for you. We're talking about a coin that is hot off the presses. Okay, it's Holochain, ticker symbol HOT. All right, that's going to be the coin for today. You'll find out about it very fast anyway, so you'll see it on the board. You have to figure out where it's going to be on the board to get the space right, so pay attention for that. But we're going to talk about a coin that's got an interesting approach to solving how to develop coins and also how to provide blockchain features to projects that don't have their own blockchain and they want to get going quickly. So Holochain has a lot of good features and a lot of good structure to it. It's explained very well by a good software engineer, and I understand that totally because I used to work with a lot of software engineers. So let's talk about Holochain, some of the features that it offers, why it's a good project, why it's a good offering, and why it's worth a gamble, not financial advice, but why it's worth a space on the Altcoinopoly board. So for piece number 9, let's first take a look at the Altcoinopoly board. Where are we at and how far have we come so far? We are still in zone 1. This is going to be the last piece of zone 1. Zone 1 is otherwise known as the cheap rent district. It is the bottom row of the board from the very start of the board all the way to the first gray box in the corner. So what's complete on the board so far? Well, I'm going to summarize this one last time, and then this is going to be the last time I point out where each particular one goes, so you're going to have to keep good notes. So here's the spaces on and the coins and the videos that are appropriate for each of the spaces. We have one more white space to go. That is coin number 9. That is today's coin. And that coin happens to be HOT or Holochain. So that coin will wrap up the cheap rent district. That is coin number 9. After this video, I will no longer put out this image. You're going to have to keep good notes. So I'll only just say that zone 1 is videos 1 through 9. And if you want to figure out which ones go where, you have to rewatch portions of videos 1 through 9. So I have to drive traffic somehow. So we're playing a game, we're having some fun with it. Today's coin is Holochain or HOT. So let's take a harder look at HOT and Holochain and dive into what this coin is all about. Okay, so HOT or Holochain. And it's very important to distinguish that when you're looking for this coin, if you're looking to invest in it, not financial advice, of course, but it's up to you. If you're looking for the HOT for Holochain, make sure that you get the right symbol and the right version of HOT, because there's more than one coin out there that uses the letters HOT for their symbol. So I'll point out 3 videos that I'll link during in the comments of this. But look for the symbol here. This is the symbol for Holochain. That is the HOT you're looking for. So what is Holochain? Holochain is an interesting approach to blockchain. What they do is they distribute the blockchains and then they aggregate them all at the end. So they use what's called an agent-centric approach versus a data-centric approach. Bitcoin does a data-centric approach where everybody has to be all aligned and then you hit go and then everyone starts trying to solve the problem to mine and get the first answer that works to build that next block. Rather than doing that, the agent-centric, every agent or node has a copy of their own blockchain and they can do whatever they want. And when they're all done, they can come back to the network and say, here's our blockchain, let's put it on the network and then build it together. Now, in this particular video here, Donald puts together a great video and a great analogy to explain this in terms of a jigsaw puzzle. Now, software developers, what they do is they go, like, imagine a bulletin board full of index cards or a set of post-it notes up on the wall. A developer will come and they'll grab one of the tasks, they'll take a card or a post-it note off of the wall, and they'll go do that task, and when they're done, they'll bring it back and put it in the done pile. Similarly, in a jigsaw puzzle, if everybody's working on a jigsaw puzzle, like 4 or 5 people trying to put together one giant puzzle at once, you can butt heads, literally, if you're trying to be all on top of the puzzle all at once. So rather than do that, you can separate the puzzle. Well, some people will do the frame, some people will do a particular object in the picture or whatever, and when those pieces are done, they'll bring it back to the main puzzle and put it all together. So that's what software engineers often do when they develop things. They develop a piece, then bring back that bigger piece to the collective larger puzzle assembly for the entire project. So Holochain, their major blockchain is the entire project, but they have agent blockchains or agent central distribution of blockchain where people can go work on their own little tasks and blockchains and then bring all their answers back when they're ready. So it's a way to distribute the task rather than having everybody try to do everything all at once. So it's an interesting approach. It's more of a software-centric developer kind of outlook. And it allows for a couple things. It allows for isolation of data so that, you know, team A can be working independently of team B, can be working independently of team C, and then teams A, B, and C don't need to share their own private data. So think of that as a company. Company A, B, and C can keep their own data, have their own blockchain, and do whatever they want. And when they're ready, they can bring whatever they choose back to the main consensus. So it's a great way to create privacy and also to distribute the task of developing blockchains that don't all have to match. So Holochain, it's an interesting approach. I kind of like it. I think it's a different viewpoint and outlook on how to develop, more of a software kind of point of view. And both Donald does a great job of explaining it. And once again, Guy did a great job of explaining it a couple years ago. And then another channel, which I don't think I've identified before, but Turnio does a good job of explaining things on his channel in very condensed little summaries. So it's these three videos I'll put in the link and you can watch them. They're not very long, but it's a pretty good explanation of three different aspects or three different viewpoints on how Holochain works. Now let's take a look at the charts and where the position of Holochain is in relation to other projects that are out there in the crypto space. Taking a look now at the charts, we have one chart for HOT versus USDT and one versus Bitcoin, and we'll look at both. Now, both of these charts are similar in shape, and what I did was it looks to me like it's a Fibonacci retracement. It's kind of a wave one and a wave two, and a wave of a five-wave pattern for Elliott wave. So wave one, typically wave two, if wave two is roughly about half the size of wave one, then wave three could be coming. And when wave three comes, it can be a massive upsurge. And that is the biggest mover of a five-wave Elliott wave theory move in a coin. So looking at the charts, going back to February, Holochain started to get some traction. There were some influencers that were making mention of Holochain a lot. A lot of traction and a lot of commentary in the last few weeks about this particular coin. One particular intuitive happened to mention this coin as one of her top coins, and another influencer worked with that intuitive. I don't want to say their names because I think that particular video is behind a paywall, but enough people know what I'm talking about that there was definitely a mention of Holochain as a top pick recently, and that sparked a lot of interest. So that was part of the time frame of this run-up in March, where the coin moved from, let's talk about it in USDT. It moved up from below a penny to over a penny quickly and got up to almost 3 cents. It was like 2.5 cents. And then it did a retrace in the last month to about 1 to 1.5 cents. So that retracement on both charts is roughly a 50% pullback. If you take from here to here and scale that to be 100%, a 50% retrace puts us right in this green golden pocket kind of area, which is about where we've been consolidating for the last several weeks for our Holochain. Now, if things play out where this winds up being, we get a wave three that moves up, I won't draw it here, but it goes up into this zone. You can see a move up to the 1.6 or 2.6 Fibonacci extension. And that just tells you that a typical wave three might go to 2.6, which we put the price up to here would be, again, it's easier to talk in U.S. dollars, so I'm going to talk in U.S. dollars. It'll go from a 1.5 penny move up to almost 4 cents to 5.5 cents. So, not financial advice, but if you were in this coin and we were looking to ladder out, putting a few sells in this range in here might be a good idea to capture the 4.5 to 5 cent range, maybe a little more, which would put it to be a 2.5 to 3.5 times move for this particular coin. So there's a good amount of upside here. There's a good amount of upside in the token. But let's frame this coin in terms of market cap and where it really exists in the whole crypto space. So looking at coin market cap quickly, Holochain is already a top 60 coin. Even on its pullback to 1.5 cents, it's down in the 2.5 billion market cap range because it has 169 billion coins. That's the thing you have to keep in mind. People will look at this coin and say, wow, it's only a penny and a half. But wait a minute. At a penny and a half, it's still number 58 on the chart. So if, let's say it goes up to 15 cents, a 10x move, that would make it almost a $25 billion coin. A $25 billion coin goes way up here to above Litecoin and near Bitcoin Cash. I don't think it's realistic in the near term for Holochain or HOT to be comparable to Chainlink, Litecoin, Bitcoin Cash, Cardano, Polkadot. It's not in that space. It's not in that regard yet. So I think a 10x move is probably a lot to ask. A 3x move is reasonable, which would put it in the, that would be, let's go back to Holochain, do some math real quick. So Holochain is at 2.5. So let's move it to 7.5 billion. What's in that range? 7.5 billion, Binance USD, Monero, PancakeSwap, above Tezos, below NEO. I think that's a reasonable range. A top 25 coin, that's a good upper bound for where it can get to. Time frame, it's always tough to determine, but I think next couple of months in an altcoin bull run, I think this is about where we can land, because these other coins that are in this space right here are also going to run up. So I think that Holochain could get to this level and maybe make a 3x move in the not too distant future in an altcoin season. But again, the thing to be most wary about is that there's a lot of coins. The market cap of 2.5 billion for a coin that's only a penny and a half, because it's got so many coins. The number of coins available is right here, almost 170 billion coins. So, and there's no cap to the max supply. Those are two warning signs for this coin. I like the technology. I like the approach. I'm just concerned about the tokenomics here. So there we go. Hot off the presses. I had to do it. You know I had to do it. Holochain. It's an interesting way to approach the problem of how to develop blockchains and applications. You can have, in the software speak, you can have things developed in pieces and then come together, like you make a branch of a code and then bring it back to the main trunk. GitHub, they understand this. You're basically breaking off a piece of the code, develop it like in a side blockchain, and then bring that side blockchain onto the main platform of blockchain. So you can have 10 or so projects all developing their own blockchain applications, and then they just, whenever they're ready, they are brought back into the main chain. So that's the approach that Holochain or HOT takes to solving how to develop applications and blockchain solutions. It's a very interesting project, but it's not all, you know, it's no project is perfect. So this one has a little bit of a drawback, and there's a lot of coins that are out there. I would hope that they scale that back at some point, but right now, because of the number of coins there in the space, I think that a reasonable upper bound for this coin is well below a dollar. I don't see it ever getting to a dollar, but I said the same thing about Doge. So you never know. But in comparison, I don't see it being a top 10 coin, which is about where it would have to be a dollar right now. That's a bit of a stretch. Could it get to a dollar? Yes, but other coins are going to have to rise as well. I just don't see it being a top 20 coin. That said, though, it has upside. It's a cheap coin right now. It has potential. It could, you know, 5 or 10x, that's definitely reasonable. It's worth a look. It's got solving a good use case. It's a good project, and it's structured well. So HOT is worth a shot, and that deserves a board on a space on. So HOT deserves a shot and a space on the Altcoinopoly board. And that's one of our coins for this week. And I think HOT completes zone one of our board. So if you're playing at home, and you should be, and you're subscribing and have all the pieces, that's 9 pieces in the first section of the board. We not completed that. And now I'm allowing myself, because I make up the rules on how I give out the coins, to jump around the board a little bit, because I think we get an idea of how the game's going to be played now. And you can see how this game's going to go. So
HOT is one of our coins now. It's one of the first nine that are released. There's still three more zones to go. So stay with us. There's plenty to come. But for now, I'm going to close the drawer on the Bureau, and I'll see you next time. Before you go, I just wanted to let you know some of the things that are going on at LitecoinLeader.com. First off, we have ALTCOINopoly running from now until the end of July. That's the subscriber contest where you can enter in to win a trip to Myrtle Beach. All subscribers who fill out the complete board, all you have to do is watch the videos, write down the piece where it goes on the board, and submit that in August, and you'll be entered in for the drawing where a trip for up to four people can come on down to Myrtle Beach, spend the week, have dinner with me, enjoy a great vacation in the August-September timeline, and be part of the feature of the probably a meetup that we're going to have centered around that experience. So that's part of what we're doing right now. Also, anyone who joins as a member to LitecoinLeader.com, you get access to all the extra special videos that we have over there, from strategy to how to build your own portfolio, not financial advice, of course, but also some extra coins that you have out there. And also for the unlimited level, you have full access to me for office hours each week. Now, for those of you who can't quite get to that point and you're not on your crypto journey at that level, that's okay. We also have some time out there. I have made some hours available for you to schedule a consultation with me. You'll find throughout the website, you can schedule a consultation with Litecoin Leader, various price points, various times. I try to make myself as available as possible. And if you're just getting started, I fully understand. We all start somewhere. We have the lowest tier available. There's also free content on YouTube. So there's plenty going on. One last thing. I almost forgot. For those of you who join at the second level up, the legacy level and higher, you get a free t-shirt, and I'll mail it to you. And in addition, you get 25% off if you send in a photo of yourself around town. You get 25% off of a one-month subscription if you're wearing a Litecoin Leader t-shirt. Just tell me what size you want, and I'll make sure you get it. That's for the $50 level and up. And then lastly, if you make that same photo and you make it at a landmark, and I can tell where you're at, so I could say, like, hey, you're at the St. Louis Arch, you're at the Toronto Space Needle, you're at the Golden Gate Bridge, something like that. So you're Manhattan, Times Square, fantastic. That's double. You get 25% off for 2 months. So come on over to LitecoinLeader.com. We get a ton going on. We have Discord. We have resources. We have articles. We have everything going on that you could possibly want for the altcoin space. Come on down, have some fun, and I'll see you over there.